Hello everyone, this is Noah, and the purpose of this video is to help those that are going to, for the very first time, put into their hands air conditioning HVAC gauges. And you may have just started working at an AC company or an HVAC company as an apprentice, and you're trying to learn the trade, or maybe you are in another field of work and you want to get into the HVAC trade. And I know the thing that intimidates a lot of new ones is the gauges, and where do I connect them, and how do I know where to connect them, and what if I get the hoses connected in the wrong place? How do I know? What tip can you give me to make sure that never happens to me? And that's the purpose of this video. So this is for someone that for the very, very, very first time, you're going to be holding gauges into your hand and you just want to know exactly where they go. So you look at your gauges and you have yellow hose in the middle, and then you have a red hose and a blue hose. So here's something that's going to help you easily determine where it goes, so you never get them crossed as far as where they connect to the condensing unit outside. So as you know, in the air conditioning world, you have red, which is represented with hot, and blue, which is cold. Actually, if you drive around town or if you look at billboards with logos with different air conditioning advertisements and commercials, you'll notice that most logos have a red and a blue. And the red is for heating, the blue is for cooling. So that's an easy way to tell. I mean, think in your head, you're on fire, you're hot, it's red. You're cold as ice, blue. So with that in mind, if you look at the line here on the right-hand side where the red hose is connected to it, this is what is known as the high side. And generally speaking, your high side, when the unit is running, it's going to be warmer than your low side here, which is this copper tube here, which is also going to be colder to the touch. So when the system is running, this is going to be warmer or hotter. This is going to be colder. One easy way to do this and to remember it in your head is, and let's choose a color here, is look at the two H's here. Hot side, high side. They both begin with the letter H. So you know that your high side, which is your high pressure, the refrigerant is flowing this way, okay, into the home, into the air handler, evaporator coil. That's your high side. And then this is also leaving the unit as a liquid. And it's returning back to the compressor as a gas. So when you keep that in mind, the way the refrigerant is flowing, and it's somewhere behind this wall is your compressor. And of course, this tube right here, after it leaves the compressor, goes through the coil, and then eventually goes here. So that's one way to remember. Hot starts with the letter H, high side also with the letter H. That's how you know. So if you were out in the field and your trainer or someone that's teaching you wants to test you and say, okay, here you have the red hose and the blue hose, go ahead and connect it to the unit. If the unit is running and you feel this side here, okay, which is your high side, is going to be hot. And of course, hot is represented by the color red. So you're going to connect your red hose to it. That's how you know. And your blue hose, which is this one here, is going to be on the colder side, which is your suction side. And you can also have little ways in your head so you can recognize this. Now, your trainer might very well tell you, I'm not going to allow you to touch the lines. I want you to memorize this and I want you to do it right. So now you can't determine which one's hot and which one's colder. Well, use other things that's going to help you. Your liquid line is also going to be smaller. So if you can pair up your smaller with your red hose, okay, and then your blue hose with the larger. That's, you can also memorize that in your head. Now, this is something I've learned through different texts that when they started, they had the same dilemma. And sometimes they'll tell you, well, In the winter time, in the winter months, it's out of the two between summer and winter, I prefer summer. Why? Because winter, you have to scrape ice, you have black ice on the road, you have accidents, you have to shovel your driveway, and they would use this phrase, winter sucks compared to summer. So then that's another way you can memorize it and use your suction line as your cold. Okay, think about winters, cold, suction line. That's another way to do it, okay? Suction, cold, blue, cold. And that's how you know your blue hose goes into your suction line, whereas your red hose goes into your liquid line. Okay, so you have your blue hose here, your red hose here, connected to the liquid line. Also known as a discharge line on the high side, or the liquid line, because remember, refrigerant, again, is being discharged from the compressor going this way. And your suction line, because it's actually creating a suction like the vacuum cleaner, where the refrigerant is returning back into the compressor as a gas, like we talked about before. So again, this is some little tips that are going to help you. So you can do this on your own. If you're being trained on the field, I'll get that later. If you're being trained on the field for the very first time and you just want to make sure you never confuse the two lines or the two hoses and get them in the wrong place, this is just a little kind of like a first day on the job gauges for dummies. So we hope it's very beneficial to you and it helped you out. Please post any questions or concerns at the comments section and we'll try our very best to answer them for you. Thank you very much and have a nice day.